Remember in the previous video we asked if we could push forward vector fields, and then we said that yes, in the case of Lie groups and left invariant vector fields on Lie groups. So what are Lie groups? So a Lie group is a group that is also a manifold such that the group operations are smooth. What we mean is the multiplication map and the inverse map are both smooth. An example of a Lie group is the general linear group. The matrix multiplication is just given by polynomials in the coordinate of the matrices anyway, so the matrix multiplication is smooth, and the inverse map is also smooth, and we can deduce that from Cramer's rule. Okay, so for Lie group, we have an additional Lie algebra. So for usual manifold, we have the Lie algebra of smooth vector fields. Now for Lie group, we have a Lie subalgebra of this, consisting of left invariant vector fields. So what do we mean by left invariant vector fields? Invariant under what? Well, observe that every element, letter G in G, induces a diffeomorphism given by left multiplication by G. Its inverse is just left multiplication by G inverse. And in the previous video, we have mentioned that even though we cannot, in general, push forward vector fields under just an arbitrary map, we can push forward vector field under diffeomorphism. So given a vector field x, we can talk about the push forward of x under left multiplication by every element g. A smooth vector field x on a G, then, is called left invariant if for every element letter g in G, we have that this push forward of x under left multiplication by g is x itself. Actually, we can drop the condition that this vector field has to be smooth, because if a vector field is left invariant, it must be smooth. We will prove this inclusion here in the next video. We will show that the left invariant vector fields have to be smooth. But now, for the rest of this video, we want to give the following important recharacterization of this. Somehow, we want to establish a bijection between this set of left invariant vector fields, actually a Lie algebra of left invariant vector fields, with a tangent space to G at the identity. Under this bijection, we're gonna put a Lie algebra structure on this, and this tangent space is then called the Lie algebra of the Lie group G. So let's explain this correspondence. We claim that every left invariant vector field, it's uniquely determined by its value at the identity. Let's see why that is. Let's take a left invariant vector field X. We claim that if we know xe, then we actually know xg for every point g in the manifold. This is because, recall previously, we have mentioned that left multiplication by this letter g is a diffeomorphism, so it induces this isomorphism on tangent spaces. Now, because x is a left invariant, we know that this push forward vector field is x itself, so that means the image of xe under this push forward is just xg. Thus, once we know xe, we can just find xg by pushing xe forward via the left multiplication by g map. Thus, we see that every left invariant vector field x is uniquely determined by its value xe in the tangent space to g at e. Now, conversely, it's easy to see that if we start with a vector space in the tangent space at the identity, then we can get an induced vector field that is left invariant, defined as follows. So at every g, this vector field is just going to be the push forward of this vector v under the left multiplication by g map. And then clearly, by definition, it's left invariant. Thus, this gives us a bijection between the set of left invariant vector fields on the Lie group g and the tangent space to the identity at the identity of g. Now, it's easy to check that the Lie brackets preserves left invariant. So this set of left invariant vector fields actually form a Lie algebra. So under this bijection, we can form a Lie algebra structure on this tangent space to G at the identity. And we call this the Lie algebra of the Lie group G.